Blooms Taxonomy is a hierarchy model used to classify thinking according to six cognitive levels of complexity. The framework consisted of six categories. The categories after knowledge were presented as skills and abilities, with the understanding that knowledge was the necessary precondition for putting these skills and abilities into practice. These six levels can be used to structure the learning objectives, lessons, and assessments of a course. When writing learning outcomes, it is easier to use an action verb derived from the domains of learning outlined in Blooms Taxonomy. This not only allows you to choose a verb which is closely linked with the assessment type, but can also help with setting the learning outcome to the right level. As learning design experts, we are promoting lower order thinking skills as well as higher order thinking skills, or LOTS and HOTS, within our learners. Through the use of a variety of teaching techniques to promote LOTS and HOTS, learners will start to implement the application, analysis, synthesis, and evaluation of new knowledge. Typically, LOTS consist of remembering, understanding, and applying. HOTS persists learners to analyze, evaluate, and create. Think of the lower order and higher order from these perspectives. Learning by repetition or rote memorization and recalling relevant knowledge from long-term memory generate the concepts of memory. The ability to understand means a learner constructs meaning from oral, written, and graphic messages. From the higher order perspective, creating refers to the arrangement of elements into a new pattern or structure through generating, designing, or producing a deliverable assignment. Many of these higher order activities require more than one skill to perform, and many of the tasks combine logical, critical, reflective, and creative thinking skills. A helpful and frequently used resource when writing student learning outcomes is Blooms Taxonomy of Cognitive Skills. When applied correctly, instructional designers can create meaningful and effective learning outcomes. Designers must carefully consider the alignment between a learner's ability to perform the learning outcome and the wording action of the objective. For example, if the learner is expected to describe course-related content, a proper assignment to measure this ability could be a course discussion with a prompt directing the learner to develop a response that demonstrates their ability to comprehend course concepts and illustrate critical assessment in their reflection. Remember, consider the delivery of your learning and apply a practical level of Blooms Taxonomy to ensure a learner can successfully execute the learning outcome.